Hello students, welcome to Ekta Science Education class. Today we are going to start very important part of plant, that is flower. But before we start, do not forget to subscribe to my channel. As you subscribe my channel, you will get the updates of the latest videos. So let's start with the today's topic. Now you can see here I have dissected the flower, and now one by one I will show you the different parts of flower. As you can see, this is activity. You can do it with me, or after watching the video you can do it separately at home. We know that flower is the most beautiful and attractive part of plant. It is also the reproductive part of the plant. It appears on the plant after it attains maturity. After the plant attains the maturity, the flower will appear on the plant. Now the flower consists of the different parts. The first part of the flower I will show you now. Students, you can see I have taken the very common example flower that is readily available in our neighboring areas. The flower which is having red bright color is the hibiscus flower. You can readily available this flower and dissect it, and the whorls are very prominently seen. So I have taken this flower. Now you can see the cylindrical portion by which a flower is attached to the stem is called the stalk. This I am showing with you my fingers. You can see the cylindrical portion by which a flower is attached to the stem is called the stalk or pedicel. In some flowers, the pedicel swells up or flattens to bear the other parts of the flower. This is called as a thalamus. The rest of the all whorls, these circular whorls जो आप देख रहे हो, गोल गोल circular whorls are arranged with this thalamus, with the support of this thalamus. All the whorls are included this way in this thalamus. Okay, after the pedicel there is a next structure, that is a sepal. The outermost, I have separated this sepal, you can see now. Okay, this is sepal. The outermost whorl of a flower, which is green and protect the other parts in the bud stage, comprises the sepal. Okay, this is also called as the calyx. This is also said to be the calyx. You can see this thalamus can be seen in this way in other plants, in other plants flowers as well. See, this is the pedicel, here is it is thalamus, and this is the sepal. Okay, here you can see again, observe the plant. After the sepal we are going to learn about the second whorl of a flower, which is a colorful and bright. You can see I have arranged this way. This bright comprises this petals. These are the petals. Petals attract insect because of this bright color. The petals are having scent also. They are having special kind of a fragrance. These are said to be the petals. Petals are collectively said to be the corolla. Okay, these petals are collectively said to be the corolla, and single member is said to be the petal. The third whorl of a flower is a group of a male reproductive part of the plant. Each of these is called a stamen. It consists of a long tubular filament and a swollen portion at its top called the anther. This bears the pollen grains or the male gametes. This is also called as the androecium. Okay, you can see here I have separated this male reproductive part. As you can see, yeah, see, now this is the anther, this long tube like structure, cylindrical, that is a filament, and this total structure is said to be the androecium, and this all complete structure is said to be the stamen. Now inside this anther, here the inside the structure is actually like this. Inside this anther there are the pollen grains, and collectively it is the male reproductive part of the flower. Male reproductive part of this flower. Now let's start the female reproductive part. It is also present here. You can see the umbrella like structure that is said to be stigma, the long tube like structure, this is a style, and at the base you can see the ovary where the ovules are formed. This total structure is said to be the gynoecium, and this is all said to be the pistil. Okay, this is the female reproductive part. Okay students, so here we can done with the structure of the plant. Both male and female reproductive part we have learned. You can do this activity at home. Just take the flower of hibiscus, dissect it and separate each and every whorl of the plant, and just you can make video